Good morning students. Today we are going to see about coordination chemistry unit 5 in first volume. Now we are going to see the coordination chemistry. You have learned already in a D block elements, that means transition elements, which is exhibit a complex compounds. So that means coordination chemistry. So then coordination name, it is derived from the Latin word which means complexes and coordination, which means to hold, to arrange respectively. So to hold, to arrange. So the complexes of transition metals have interesting properties which is differ from simple ion as well as covalent compounds. For example, you may see chromium 3 chloride hexahydrate. The formula is CrCl3 6H2O, exhibits purple color, pale color, green color or dark green color also. This is known as coordination chemistry. It means, it is a Latin word, means complexes, to hold, to arrange. So especially all the transition elements are exhibit this coordination compounds, right? So why we are taking this coordination complexes, means it is day-to-day life, it is used more in our life. First one is application usually in our blood. The hemoglobin is present, you know, the hemoglobin, the oxygen transporter of cumin, is a coordination compound of iron. Iron is what? Fe compound, Fe2 plus oxidation state. It is act as a central metal ion, and as well as also cobalamin. Cobalamin is an essential vitamin, is a coordination compound of cobalt. One more thing, chlorophyll also. Chlorophyll, which is used in photosynthesis process, it is act as a sensitizer. In photosynthesis process, without chlorophyll, we can't prepare the food, isn't it? So this chlorophyll is also one of the coordinated complex. It is magnesium present in the central metal ion, that is Mg2 plus is present. This is act as a photosensitizer. So have many uses. So the coordination compounds will be used in many applications in our day-to-day life. So now we are going to see what is coordination compounds, how it is prepared. So the coordination compounds, how it is prepared? When two or more stable compound in solution are mixed together. So two or more stable compounds, any two compounds we are taking, so solutions are mixed together and allowed to evaporate. After boiling, it will be evaporate, no? After allowed to evaporate, it gives some certain compounds. That is known as maybe a coordination compound, as maybe a double salt. So for example, we may take in ferric chloride, what will be the formula? FeCl3 plus and potassium thiocyanate solution, potassium thiocyanate compound. This potassium thiocyanate compound will be treated, both are combined, it may gives the compound of K3. So FeCN6 compound. So ferric chloride compound as well as potassium thiocyanate. So two compounds are mixed in solution form. It is actually gives the blood red colored coordination compound. So potassium ferric thiocyanate compound. This is actually complex. This is K3 FeCN6 thiocyanate compound. This is actually coordinated compound. One more example for this, and FeCN2 plus 4KCN. One more example, FeCN2. It is also ferric cyanide compound. It is treated with the KCN. It gives the compound FeCN as well as 4KCN. Or else we shall write this compound like that: K4 square bracket FeCN6 and Fe4KCN compound can be dissociated into 4K plus, and again this is a plus symbol denotes that cation, as well as here minus symbol. So this two compound will be, so this whole compound can be dissociated like that, K plus as well as FeCN6 compound complex. So this is cation and this is complex anion, will be dissociated. So the coordinated compound can be dissociated and the individual compounds can lose their identity. The metal of the complex ion is not free in solution, unlike metal double salts. So the coordination compounds, when added two compounds in solution, are mixed together and allowed to evaporate, it gives the common coordination common, and it can be dissociated. So what will be the double salt? So see here, the double salt, the same thing, that these are molecules or compounds which are formed by the evaporation of solution, they are containing two or more salts in stoichiometric proportions. Hence the molecular compounds in stoichiometric proportions, the molecular compounds which is dissociate in solution in its constituent ions, this is known as double salt. Double salts retain their properties only in solid state. So it can retain their own property in solid state. So they are also called lattice compounds. For example, we may give for double salts, potassium, that is potash alum, K2SO4 and AlSO4 thrice and 24H2O. One more thing, more salt also, FeSO4, NH4 twice, SO4 as well as 6H2O. And this compound can be dissociated. So this constituent ions, but in solid state, the double salts gives the test of all their constituent ions in solution form. So K2SO4, the potassium alum, if it is dissociated, it is also dissociated into K plus as well as Al3 plus, again 4SO4 2 minus as well as 2H2, 24H2O. This is known as double salt. Now we are going to see, so what will be the difference between the double salt as well as coordination compounds? Both are combined, combination of two or more compounds. Now what will be the difference between double salt as well as coordination compounds? The double salt is compound prepared by the combination of two different salt components. At the same time, coordination compound is also compound composed of a central metal atom having coordination bonds with the ligands. What will be the central metal ion as well as ligand, we will see later. Second thing is completely dissociate into ions in water in mid solution form. Do not completely dissociate into ions in water, but in this complex compound, after forming complex, it cannot be dissociated in water, and it gives simple ions when it is added with the water. Double salt can produce simple ions, but after forming complex, it do not form any simple ions. It can be easily analyzed by determining the ions present in the aqueous solution, but the complex compound cannot be easily analyzed. So you can see example, potash alum, K2SO4, AlSO4 thrice as plus 24H2O. At the same time, for complex, we are taking potassium ferrocyanide. So potassium ferrocyanide, K4FeCN6. So this is known as difference between and double salt as well as coordination compounds. See here, the double salt as well as coordination compounds, the double salt can be easily dissociated. At the same time, it's a constituent simple ions, but it cannot coordination compounds. What will be the coordination compounds? So the potash alum, more salt, everything will be a double salt. Potash alum, already K2SO4, AlSO4, 24H2O, you have seen already in the, it is actually potash alum used for arresting bleeding also. It is used for arresting bleeding. It is already, you can see in the barber shop also, they are using potash alum. It is one of the filtration, potash alum used in the filtration process also. This is known as coordination compound. So now we are going to see coordination. So once again, I recall this compound, complexes. So coordination is what? Complexes, it's a Latin word, as well as coordination, which means to hold, to arrange, right? And it is producing covalent bonds. An example, chromic chloride hexachloride, chromium 3 chloride hexahydrate, CrCl3 6H2O, exits purple color. It may have many applications. Thank you, students. You will see you next class.